Sometimes we need to create rounded or flattened corners in our drawing. In AutoCAD, we can convert a simple corner to a rounded corner with a Fillet Tool. We can also convert a sharp corner to a sloped or angled corner with a Chamfer Tool. To understand how the Fillet and Chamfer Tools can be used, two drawings with some examples have been created in advance. I should mention that the Fillet as well as the Chamfer Tool can both be found in either the Modify menu or in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Firstly, we need to learn how the Fillet tool works. Once I activate Fillet, I have to define its radius. So I will click on the radius option in the command line, and as the shape on the left indicates, I will type the number 22 and press Enter to specify the radius. Then, I will select the horizontal line first and then the vertical line. The fillet is finished and the command deactivated automatically. Moving to the next example, I will show you how to perform multiple fillets without activating the command over and over again. I will activate Fillet and click on the multiple option in the command line. Then, I will click on the radius option, type the number 10 and press Enter to specify it. I will select the two lines of the corner and notice that even though the corner becomes rounded, the command remains active. I will select the radius option again, type the number 5 and press Enter to specify the new radius. Then I will select the rest of the lines of the corners I want to become rounded. Once I no longer need the Fillet tool, I will press either Enter or Escape to deactivate it. I will move to the last fillet example to show you something quite interesting. We can perform fillet in arc and circles too. With the Fillet tool active, I will set the radius to 19 and select the multiple option. Then I will select the right side of the small circle first and then the right side of the bigger one. I will repeat the procedure for the left side and notice that now the two circles are connected by two arcs which are tangent to both circles. At this point, I will move on to the next drawing to show you how the chamfer tool works. We can chamfer a corner using two different methods. We can either specify the horizontal and vertical distance of the chamfer, or we can specify one of the two distances and the angle. But let's see the difference in an example. In the first example, I will activate the command and then I will select the distance option in the command line. Now, a message prompts me to specify the first chamfer distance. I will type the number 5 and press Enter. Then, another message prompts me to specify the second chamfer distance. This time, I will type the number 10 and press Enter. Next, I will select the horizontal line of the corner first, and then the vertical line. The chamfer is finished and the command deactivated automatically. Notice that the first distance was applied to the line that I selected first, while the second distance applied to the line that I selected last. In the next example, I will activate the chamfer tool again, but this time I will select the angle option in the command line. Again, a message prompts me to specify the first chamfer distance, so I will type the number 12 and press Enter. The second message prompts me to specify the chamfer angle from the first line. So I will type the number 30 and press Enter. All I have to do now is select the first line and then the second. Once again, the command deactivated automatically. Lastly, I will show you how to perform multiple chamfers without activating the command over and over again. So, once I activate chamfer, I will click on the multiple option in the command line. Then, I will click on the distance option and I will set the first distance to 10 and the second to 5. I will chamfer the left upper angle and notice that the command remains active. So I will also chamfer the lower right corner and then I will press either Enter or Escape to deactivate the command manually.